Happy day after Divine Mercy Sunday. It's Monday, and I was going to make a video yesterday, but as you know, if you're a parent, time just goes by, slips by. But I wanted to share some thoughts, reflections on the homily from yesterday. The priest was talking about how when he was in seminary not too long ago, just a few years ago, his advisor, there's people gonna fish right behind me while I'm trying to make a video. That's kind of distracting. What if I do this? So the priest was saying how his advisor was, he said, you know, all this stuff, all these liberal policies, especially geared toward children and transgenderism and whatnot, they're all to lower the age of consent. And I thought, wow, that, I think he's spot on with that. And he also said, I mean, by the way, look at what Disney just came out. They're admitting they want to make queerness an element in all these kids shows. Why would you sexualize children like that? Like, queerness is about sexuality. Wow. Yeah, I shouldn't. I mean, when I was that age, when I was a kid, sex wasn't really a thing, you know? You puberty and later, but man, sexualizing our children, that is disgusting. And we need to protect the innocence of our children. And so there's a lot going on about that. But the other point I liked that resonated with me was he said that the priest said, if this generation tolerates this nonsense, the next generation is going to take it as truth. They will accept it. There will be no question. So, for example, men can have babies. Like, what? Okay, right now there's this push to tolerate that. I mean, first of all, it goes against reasoning, it goes against human nature. So if we're just gonna tolerate and say men can have babies, then our children are going to take that as fact. And the last point, the priest mentioned a passage from 1984. And I forget the exact quote, how the quote went, but basically it was, basically the best thing that the government can do in terms of power for themselves is when we as people, and when we just don't question what we see and what we hear. And that's spot on. I mean, look at the pandemic and all the things, like right in this building, at the park, I go in the building, this says a sign, mask required in restroom and lobby. Like, okay, first of all, there's nobody in this lobby. Second of all, in the bathroom. I mean, yeah. And so this virus is gonna go in the bathroom and not in another room? Just doesn't make any sense. So when we like are silent, when we suppress our own senses, and that's when the government wins, that's when the people in power win. I mean, going back to the men can have babies example, when we like look at your eyes, look at yourself, are you a man or are you a woman? It's obvious. It's fact. It's biological fact. It's look, you use your eyes, use your senses. The government, what they're doing, and the media, all these powerful forces are working to suppress our senses, and we're willingly letting them do that. We're like lulled to sleep. Oh yeah, I don't know. Vagina, penis, I don't know. What's that? That Supreme Court justice, the new one, she's like, I don't know what a woman is. I'm not a biologist. I'm not a scientist. Okay, so wait. scientists do say that women have vaginas, men have penises, and different chromosomes. So that's the science. So these people in power, okay, they are nuts. So that, use your senses, use your sight, smell, taste, all these things God gave us. And if we just suppress them, we are letting the devil win. So now, how does all this tie into Divine Mercy Sunday? I don't remember. It was just like, oh, this priest is spot on. But the fact is, we are immersed in God's mercy, and we need to return to Him. First, if you are not a believer, return to your senses. That's, I think, primary. God speaks through our created world. How else would He speak to us? So get back to your senses, look around you. Just, you can easily see what's real, right? You can look within, and God's all around. His mercy abounds. Thank God for our Lord and Savior who came and died on the cross for us and is constantly pouring out His mercy upon us. And even in this corrupt world, like, He is pouring the graces. We just have to ask and receive. It's that simple. So I hope you all had a blessed Divine Mercy Sunday, and I encourage you all to pray the Divine Mercy Chaplet. I go through phases with my prayers, like my devotions, and I think I'm gonna get back into this Divine Mercy one. Yesterday at my parish, we had Eucharistic Adoration at 3 p.m., the Hour of Mercy, and we prayed the Divine Mercy Chaplet, and it was beautiful, so beautiful to meditate on God's mercy. So look it up, Chaplet of Divine Mercy. God bless you. Happy day after Divine Mercy Sunday. And don't forget, it is still the Easter season. It's Eastertide. Easter is such a holy day, such a wonderful holiday in the church that it's celebrated for 8 straight days. So it's not just one day, it's 8 days long. And after that, it's the whole season. We've got a whole season of Easter. So praise God. Christ is risen. Truly, He is risen.